In this webcast, we're going to see that cycloaddition reactions, which were forbidden thermally, become allowed when one of the partners is in the photoexcited state. These are known as photocycloaddition reactions. The three reactions shown here, the 2 plus 2, the 4 plus 4, and the 6 plus 6, are thermally forbidden but photochemically allowed cycloaddition reactions. Like other cycloadditions, photocycloadditions are both stereospecific and regiospecific. Their stereospecificity and regiospecificity, as well as their allowedness, depends on the frontier molecular orbitals involved between the two reacting partners. Before I provide you with an example of an FMO analysis for a photocyclization, let me first introduce a couple of terms, superfacial and anterofacial. Superfacial means that the bonding interactions, which are going to take place on the ends of the molecule, are going to take place from the same pi face. And so here's a pi face. I'm drawing the plane, the nodal plane. And you can see that both of the bonding interactions in a superfacial reaction are going to involve the lower lobe. So this reaction, the one on the left, would be superfacial for the partner that's on the top and superfacial for the partner on the bottom. We'd say this is a superfacial plus superfacial interaction. Compare that to the case where the bonding is on opposite pi faces, as shown here. That's what's known as an anterofacial reaction. In an anterofacial reaction, one bonding interaction takes place below the pi plane, and the other interaction takes place above the pi plane. And so this reaction would be suprafacial in the blue partner and anterofacial in the green partner, one being below and one being above. That gives the right phase matches, the shaded matches the shaded, the unshaded matches the unshaded. Now let's take a look at an FMO analysis for the 2 plus 2 photocyclization reaction. From the last webcast, it should not be too surprising that the most important FMO interactions are going to be between homostar on the excited state molecule and HOMO on the ground state molecule. Another possible FMO interaction would be between LUMOSTAR and LUMO. You can see that in either of these cases, the phases are matched for a superfacial plus superfacial interaction in the 2 plus 2 cycloaddition. Now consider the 4 plus 2 reaction, which is thermally allowed superfacial plus superfacial, but photochemically forbidden. The reason why it's photochemically forbidden is because there's a mismatch in the phases. Take the case of the HOMO star interacting with HOMO. We see that one end has phase matched, but the other end is phase mismatched for the superfacial-superfacial interaction. The same thing applies for the LUMO star-LUMO interaction. A 4 plus 2 photocycloaddition is allowed if one partner reacts anterofacially and the other one reacts suprafacially. We can see this for the HOMO-STAR-HOMO interaction by looking at both ends. There we can see the bottom lobe of the 4pi partner and the top lobe of the 4pi partner interacting with the same face of the 2pi partner. That would be anterofacial in the 4pi partner and suprafacial in the 2pi partner, and it would be an allowed cycloaddition, but it's too strained, the ring size is too small, to allow the top end of the 4pi partner and the bottom end of the 4pi partner to span across the two ends of the 2pi partner. For larger ring systems, these anterofacial suprafacial interactions are possible. Let's summarize and focus only on the suprafacial plus suprafacial rules, specifically looking at the conditions for allowedness. In the three reactions that you see here, these are all photochemically allowed, and they all involve a certain number of pi electrons. The 2 plus 2 cycloaddition involves 4 pi electrons. The 4 plus 4 cycloaddition involves 8 pi electrons. And the 6 plus 6 cycloaddition involves 12 pi electrons. These numbers are all multiples of 4, where 4Q is going to either be 4, 8, or 12. And each of those reactions are photochemically allowed. The 4Q plus 2 reactions, which would be 6 electrons, 10 electrons, or 14 electrons, are thermally allowed suprafacial plus suprafacial cycloaddition reactions. What we learned from the last webcast, the trends that we're used to for thermal reactions are turned upside down in photochemical processes. We'll see more of this in the upcoming webcast.